morning, everyone. My name is Simran. I'm the student of Biology History. The topic of my paper is Buildings as Memories, a case study of the Patna Collectorate. Patna Collectorate is a building complex located near the banks of the river Ganga in the district of Patna. At present, it is the seat of the district headquarters. The structure underwent different phases of construction over the period of time. Originally, it was constructed by the Dutch. Ulam Hussain Khan of the Bali and Siyarul Muttakarim mentions about the factory of the Dutch at Azimabad, which is a house of great beauty furnished with cannon and men. This structure is partly marked by the old northern block of the Patna College building, one of the few sites associated with the Dutch, which is still intact. When the Dutch established their factory in Patna in the 17th century, it became the outlet for the commodities, mainly textiles, salt bitter, and opium, that were brought into its emitting ground by the river for sale. For this purpose, the Dutch constructed various storehouses along the banks of the river. Only few of them survive to this date, which includes the present-day administrative block of the Patna College, the Patna Collectorate, and only remnants can be found of the ones in Muzaffarpur. The exact year of the construction cannot be traced, but looking at the trajectories of the Dutch trade in Patna, it was most probably constructed in the late 17th or early 18th century, and it was likely to be an opium storehouse. Between the 17th and 18th century, the ownership of this structure was passed between the English and the Dutch following the treaties between them that were concluded throughout their tussle. The Anglo-Dutch Treaty of 1824, according to which Dutch settlements in India and British settlements in the Dutch East Indies were to be exchanged, the Patna Collectorate, along with the other Dutch settlements in Patna, finally came under the English in 1825. After occupying it, the English did construction around it, adding elements of British architecture in the structure, and made it their administrative headquarters. More construction happened around the structure in the 20th century when it became the administrative center of the Patna. A meeting hall was constructed in the British architectural style, of which only ruins are left today. Because of this association with Dutch, English, and India, it is considered as a shared heritage. Moving on to the common perception regarding the complex. Since the office of the district commissioner is situated in the complex, people visit here often because of their work. But if asked about the building complex itself, the reply comes in the form of question accompanied with a laugh. What is, quote unquote, historical about this? The reaction is not very unexpected, looking at the present condition of the building. Furthermore, the common perception prevalent about a historical building is related to its beauty, the unique architectural elements, the intricate designs, a proper historical figure or event associated with it are what make a building historical in the eyes of the common people. The Collectorate too has unique features of the Anglo-Dutch architecture with high ceilings and peculiar skylights and the history of centuries of the common commercial activities taking place in the city of Patna associated with it. But unfortunately, even if the people are made acquainted about the origin of the structure, the reaction would not be that welcoming unless they are historians or someone who has interest in heritage. For them, it is just a part of European heritage that has been constructed in Patna, a structure which has no relation whatsoever with the cultural nature of the city. Rather, according to them, it is a symbol of oppression by the Europeans. This perception towards the Collectorate became very clear when a few years ago the demolition of this building was being discussed. The common people did not have an opinion about it or did not bother to think of preserving old Anglo-Dutch building complex in the city. The only appeals for its preservation came from the historians and few other individuals. Here, memory becomes important. The use of the term collectorate by the native people, to some extent, preserves the memory of it being a collectorate under the British. Even the huts adjoining the building is known as collectorate hut. Even though people do not know about the origin of this structure, by using this term in their everyday life, they somehow contribute in preserving this structure as memory for the generations to come. Observing this common perception towards the structure, different questions arise. Should the Collectorate be seen as a cultural heritage or just as an old building which can be replaced by a new one? Will its demolition have an effect on the understanding of the history of the city? These are some of the questions that I will attempt to answer for the newspaper. Also, I'll try to analyze how the study of the structure, bureaucratic structure like this, can lead to a broader view of the history of the city. So, Collectorate as a living witness of the history of Patna as an antropod. The Collectorate has witnessed both the development as well as the downfall of the city as an antropod. When it was constructed, the overseas trade was growing in the city as a result of establishment of European factories. It was the phase of greatest development of Patna as an antropod. In the 19th century became the phase of the decline of the city as an antropod. As a result of the taking over of the administrative rule by the British, followed by several other developments. After the Patna began emerging as an antropod before the Europeans established their settlements there. When the Mughal rule strengthened over Bengal, Patna became an important antropod for the movements of goods from the region. This was the reason that in 1620, Patna was described as the cheapest market town of Bengal. After the arrival of the Europeans, the growth in the commercial activities by the indigenous Asian and the European merchants led to the rise of Patna as a trading and commercial hub. Because of its strategic location, being at the crossroads of both riverine and overland routes, it emerged as one of the most important commercial towns. The volume of trade happening between Patna and other cities of Bengal grew with the commercial activities of the European companies in the region. The increasing overseas trade led to the further development of Patna as an entrepreneur. In the later part of the 19th century, when the British firmly established themselves, assuming political rule as well, the city started experiencing downfall as an antropod. The most important factor that made the city a significant antropod was its geographical location and its relationship with its hinterland. But with the development of railways in the 1860s, this geographical advantage did not prove to be of much use. The goods that were sent via Patna now could be sent directly to the places. As a result, the role of Patna as a trade center was down, diminished. Another noticeable change was the relationship between the city and the hinterland. According to Bukhani's report, the city of Patna constituted 70.8% of the export trade of Patna and other districts of Bihar, and 91% of imports. These figures changed drastically after the development of the railways. By the early 20th century, the share of Patna in the trade of Patna, Gaya and Shahabad decreased from 63.5% to 23.4%. Earlier, it used to be the center for the distribution of goods to different places. Gradually, the markets reached evenly throughout the district, diminishing the role of Patna as a central market. Ralph Fitch, in the 16th century, described the region as a long and great town. Since then, the city had been growing in length along the banks of the river Ganga until the 19th century. Thus, the city became even larger over the period of time. Along with this, the city also was growing in population. The migration of different merchants, workers, shops received impetus in the 17th century, and the population kept growing since then. Bukhanan in his report mentions that even though the parts of the town along with factories declined, the city had greatly increased with the value of land doubling in 15 years, thereby making it difficult to find a spot for building a house. Thus, although the city as an antropod declined, it did not result in the decline of the city as a whole. Collectorate also reflects the transformations that happened in the city over a period of time. After the establishment of the Dutch and English factories, Patna underwent a great transformation economically, physically, culturally, and politically. In the early accounts of foreign travelers visiting Patna, like that of Tavernier, Manucci, Kravitch, each of them mentions about the houses being made of mud and having thatched roofs. But during the later part of the 17th century, a change can be noticed in the description of the city. When it was the Graf visited Patna in the 1670s, he describes the city as a Moorish city, where there are presence of hammams, gateways, towers, encircling walls, and different religious establishments, making it look like a city in North India. He talks about the fine houses, temples, and pagodas, etc. that were present there. He also mentions about a large and beautiful castle with towers and bulwarks in front. Although the description of the Lodge does not seem too reliable, if it is studied with the other travelogues, it cannot be denied that different kinds of structures started to appear in the city of Patna, of which these storehouses are also an important part. Therefore, a transformation of the physicality of the city can be observed after the establishment of European settlements there. The boost in trade and commerce in Patna in the 17th century made it essential to develop a proper banking business in the region in order to cater the financial needs of trade. As a result, a community of bankers developed in the city for providing financial services in order to facilitate long-distance trade. Patna became a major center of banking business in the subcontinent. The bankers did not only emerge in the city itself, but many bankers moved from other places to establish their business in the city. Most important among them is Jawad Sheth, who moved from Rajasthan to Patna to set up his banking firm. Emergence of such communities in the city became the reason for the rise of middle class. Education received impetus, and various literary courses were carried out in the 17th and 18th century Patna. The services required by the European companies to carry out their trade were not just financial. Patna had economic potential to meet the production needs of the commodities that were greatly in demand, mainly opium and salt pigeon. For the purpose of the movement of these goods, they needed to hire carts or boats, so they employed laborers for these purposes. Some of these laborers used to be peasants and during off-season used to work as laborers. Thus, a new different labor class emerged. Tavernier describes Patna as a cosmopolitan town. Merchants from northern and western India and Central Asia engaged in trading activities in Patna. Earlier, Patna's export trade was mainly under the Mughal, Armenian, and Pathan merchants. As the whole of the European trading groups strengthened, the importance of these merchants diminished. Also, the Europeans had different methods of organization of trade and policies of purchase. Thus, the cosmopolitan nature of Patna remained the same, but the nature of the town changed. The Patna Collectorate has been listed as the heritage structure of the city. In Patna, a monumental history published by the Art, Culture and Youth Department of Bihar government in 2008. Yet, the government took criticism of demolishing it. The negligence shown towards this collectorate is disappointing. The paper and documents related to it have already been lost. There is a severe lack of documentation on the history of the city. Keeping in mind the absence of mentions about the collectorate in different works related to the city, it becomes very important to preserve the structure in order to prevent the erasure of the memory of the space and the history associated with it. More structures like this have already been demolished. At this point, the collectorate remains one of those few structures that act as a link between the city and its past as a commercial town. Its demolition will create a big gap in understanding the history of the city. If the negligence towards the structures continues, then we would be left with only a bunch of names with no visible structure to associate with it with and tell a story. The Patna Collectorate is not just an old Anglo-Dutch specimen of architecture, but a structure which has been witnessed changes within the city over centuries and has experienced the effects of those changes in the social and economic living of the city.